Welcome back to Southeast Texas Weekly. Maya Turner and her mother, Nadria, are here to give us the student and the parent perspective on this topic. Maya, you are very, very involved in school, so we have lots of pictures to show people of all of your involvement. Tell us about everything that you do at school in order to prepare you to be and do what you want to do after high school.
Well, I'm in marching band. I'm the band captain. I'm also class president and in NHS, the secretary, and that's about it.
Yeah, and so so you're very busy after school and probably during school, and with being the class president, that means you're going to have to organize things. It doesn't end with just your senior year. You're going to have to organize some things, you know, reunions and stuff like that later on. So obviously, your classmates have a lot of faith in you to be able to elect you to that position. So you're right in the throes of all of this application process to trying to go to the school that you want to go to. You told me in the break that you were applying to four schools. What are those schools?
Baylor, UT, Texas A&M, and University of Houston.
In your heart of hearts, which one do you want to go to?
I want to go to Baylor.
Okay. Well, I was going to see if we had any Longhorn, you know, A&M rivals going on here. So you want to go to Baylor. What application have you done so far?
I've finished my application for Baylor, but I'm still in the process for the other three.
Okay. So how did you start this process? How did you and your mom, and mom chime in any time, how did you start the process of, number one, narrowing down those schools that you wanted to go to? Like, how did you choose that?
Well, the biggest thing, I want to stay in Texas.
Yeah.
So I started off, at Apply Texas, and then looked at some of the schools on there. And then after I researched those independently, I started to apply.
Okay. So what do you want to do when you graduate? Like, what do you want to major in?
I want to major in biology.
Okay. So is one of the reasons that you chose Baylor because they have a good biology program?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So mom, you're helping with this process, and it's kind of daunting, I'm sure. Because I remember, it was a long time ago that I did it, but I still remember how I'm like, oh my gosh, all these deadlines, the scholarship deadlines and the financial aid deadlines and the college application itself. Deadline. So how are you guys keeping yourselves organized?
Well, first of all, Maya is very organized, and she pretty much is a self-starter, so she did a lot of things on her own, keeping a close communication with the school, being aware of what's going on. Early in the segment, you spoke with the counselor, and she talks about knowing your requirements. Have you met the requirements? Over the summer, after she narrowed down which schools she were interested in, we traveled to a couple of the schools. Actually, one of the schools she didn't name, but we took a tour of that school, told to go and try to get a feel of what it's like, what the college has to offer, and based towards what her future goals are.
And that's a good point. We haven't talked about that yet. It's so important to go to the schools that you want to apply, because the atmosphere of the school and the feeling that you get there, especially if this is your first time being away from home, which I'm feeling it will be, make a good determination. You can kind of, do I get a good feeling from this school? Are these people the kind of people that I want to hang out with when I study and when I come to live here? Because you will be away from home, for most of these. So that's a great point. So you took the summer and you traveled around to the different schools, and then what happened next?
After traveling to the school, they have someone there from different areas of the school. We met with a financial aid representative. We met with academic advisors with that area. We actually toured areas. She's interested in science, so we were able to go to science departments and see.
Nice.
We also toured dormitories. That's a big one, especially when we're talking about student safety, because, as you said, it's her first time being away from home. And also parents would like a sense of security as well while their kids are away. So actually knowing the area of the school, what type of, what community the school lies in is a big one for me as a parent.
Right.
So that was interesting for us and one of the main reasons why we toured the different campuses.
Yeah. So which one are you hoping she gets into? Where are you hoping she goes?
I like Baylor. I will say I like Baylor. But wherever she decides, then I will support her decision.
Yeah. So where are you in the financial aid, the scholarship applications, that kind of thing? Have you started that process?
I've started applying to different scholarships. Right now I'm in the process of writing all my scholarship essays.
Yes.
So hopefully I can finish that pretty soon. It just seems like a lot of essays.
Yeah, so how are you getting people to proofread those for you once you finish them and kind of get a second eye on those?
Yeah, I'm lucky because she's an English teacher.
So yes, you are very lucky. you have an in-house proofreader.
I just email it to her and say, hey, I emailed you a paper, and then she'll proofread it.
Yeah. So, mom, advice for mother, for other, and we're almost out of time, so real quick, advice for parents who are getting ready to go through this or who are going through this, what's the biggest thing that you found out that's helped you?
To start now.
Yeah.
Don't procrastinate. A lot of times students think, well, you know, I have the rest of the senior year. We've already made it through the first 6 weeks of school, so not to wait.
Yeah.
A lot of schools offer early application deadlines. You talked about their class ranking, mm-hmm. and that helps a lot. So with the early application process, because it could be a little overwhelming and for a student who waits until the last minute to have to write a series of essays in a short time.
Exactly. All right. Thank you so much. That does it for this segment of Southeast Texas Weekly. Hopefully you got some information that will help you. Have a great weekend.